Just look at Liv's beautiful position. This is where we're going with this pose. I still hope to get there one day. That's perfection. Meredith, beautiful.
If you were somewhere where you didn't have, say, bolsters, mm-hmm. would that work with the same purpose if you had, say, the arms on
absolutely.
A chair?
Absolutely, yes, definitely. But it's even better if the body can feel something, okay. the body rather than the arms.
Sure.
Yeah, look, a pillow will do. Mm-hmm. Anything. Rolled up mat, perfect. Now, the practitioners, I'm going to work on Susie for a second. Could the practitioners come over here? You already know how to do this. You can work on anyone you want. I want to show you the technique that we use to gently separate the fascial adhesions in gracilis and the inner hamstring. Now, if you just feel her other leg, this is, and don't go all the way forward just for a second, just sit up there, that's lovely. If you, this thing, this rope that I have under my fingertips, you can feel the same. Can you feel that?
Yep.
That is gracilis. Now, here's the thing. This muscle here is completely relaxed, and the inner hamstring is nowhere near as tight as gracilis. Can you feel that?
Yep.
There's this, and this muscle here, relatively relaxed. It is only where these two are stuck together, and look at the face, you can see straight away. So what we do is we come up to here, where in fact they're completely separate. Can you feel the? They're completely separate. And run your fingers along like this, backwards and forwards, and pull back. Backwards and forwards, across, backwards and forwards. Exactly. Wait.
Ooh.
What's that?
Is it a slight stretch, you would say?
No, she's actually in a strong stretch position, or you were, weren't you? She couldn't go down to the ground. So, and it's much more effective when you apply these manual corrections in the stretch position. Now here, the fingers are going in about that far in between those two muscles, and it's effortless. But you can still feel it's that muscle, right? Absolutely. Well, no, you can't do it yourself. Your body won't let you. You can try it. And I've got very strong willpower, but I certainly couldn't do it to myself. Okay. Take a breath in and let yourself go down.
Magic.
Okay. Feel the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Totally different sensation. It's not magic. I don't know how many times I've done this in workshops. You feel the difference?
Mm. Yep.
It's a fascial adhesion, and no one writes about this. It's definitely going to be part of the next book though. This is, in my experience, this is the most important of the adhesions to release in the body. It's not in any way dangerous. It will leave you bruised though, I can tell you. One woman came into the workshop, I can't remember where it was, and she said, I had a hard time explaining this to my husband. And she pulled her pants up, she's wearing those Lululemon pants, pulled them right up to here, and she had this line of bruising down the inside of each thigh. It's normal. And absolutely no problem whatsoever. Anytime you release fascia, there will be that kind of effect. Beg your pardon?
Does it stay released? We've gone through the
absolutely.
Process.
How to explain this briefly. It's a restriction to your normal range of movement. Well, actually, let me take a step back from that. Just think about this for a moment. The fact that you're in a stretch position, feeling a stretch, means, by definition, you're out of your normal range of movement. This is not part of your movement pattern. We're literally looking into the abyss. But once you move in there, backwards and forwards a few times, just go up and down a few times, just feel the ease in the body doing it, right? And the brain is reflecting and checking this, and all the proprioceptors are remapping. When she goes to stretch this part next time, that apprehension and that pain in that particular part just simply won't be there. It does seem like magic, I know, but it's real. That's There are other muscles in the body that exhibit this similar, let me just think around the body. This is the most spectacular one. And because this limits everyone's movement, I mean, everyone wants to put their chest on the floor, right? Go for it. Off you go.
I just say on that subject, if you don't change the movement habits, it can really...
Exactly. But the point is, once you get access to the abyss and you explore it, you'll want to go back there again and again and again, because it's something you've been trying to do for years, right? That's how it works. And so to pick up on what Craig said, which is completely accurate, it now becomes part of your movement pattern, and as a result, no sticking.
Because I work with a lot of kids, and even my son, who is very flexible, he's very fine. When he does that in this stretch, he can't roll his hips forward at all. And I call my early years, I couldn't, and then one day I could.
Yep.
But I never figured out what happened.
No, well, this is the limitation. The movement of the hips forward, when your legs are apart, that's all gracilis.
Yeah.
Gracilis and the inner hamstring.